It's the middle of November, and we're staying in Guilin, China. We were here for about 3 days. It's known for the Karst mountains. We're arriving from the airport. The airport's about a 40-mile trip. It's Angela in the back. This is our hotel, Riverview Hotel, Homeland Riverview. That's our room. Nothing spectacular. It was clean, had a nice view, nice bathroom. Overlooking the Li River, L-I, Li River. This is taken from the hotel room, overlooking the river. You see the reflection in the glass there. We took a walk. We're on a bridge going over to what they call Seven Stars Park. Guilin's only about 620,000 people, so traffic wasn't as bad. Having some noodles. They tasted pretty good. I don't know why I had such a sour look on my face. Now we're in the Seven Park, Seven Star Scenic Area. It's about 1 square mile. Again, since most people in China live in these big high-rise, they utilize these parks a lot. That's where they get their exercise, their fresh air, and what have you. That's a little shuttle car that we take around. A lot of water features, nice waterfalls. The sign there says, please do not paddle, I guess if you fall in. They're noted for wild monkeys. And they were actually pretty friendly. They call them half wild. Notice a little baby hanging out of the bottom of mama. People gave them a lot of oranges and tangerines and things. They have little stalls along the walks, little vendors. That's a wedding cart, wedding carriage. Local delivery vehicle. That's a dentist office. A dentist offices were storefront. Kind of reminded me of a little shop of horrors with this guy in the back having some teeth worked on. These were fishing areas. They had these pools. There were about 8 or 9 of these pools, and people were fishing in there. The water looked pretty bad, but it is what it is. That goes down into a shopping center. We went to the Red Flute Cave. It's a huge set of caverns. That's the inside of a train that actually took us up. The caves are very pretty inside. They were all lighted with neon lights, and the different formations were named. Different things such as Manhattan, the curtains, things like that. They were actually used a lot by the people during the World War II when Japan was invading them. People took refuge in these caves. And our admission was pretty reasonable, and they gave us a guide, an English-speaking guide, just for the two of us, which was really nice. That's the curtains. If you look there, there's a lion. Now we're outside. We left the caves and we went to the Xingyang Palace. This was actually built in the year 1372. It was rebuilt back in 1947. Now we're at the Elephant Hill Scenic Area. This is a big rock that looks like an elephant drinking. According to the legend, an elephant was sick during a baggage caravan, and he was left to die by an uncaring emperor. Was nursed back to health, and then when the emperor came back on the return, he killed it, and the thing was turned into stone. We're on this reed raft. You have people doing their laundry along the river. The Lee River has a lot of these boats running up and down. This is a business section on the river. I think it was a restaurant or something. They do make a living there. They also sleep in those tents. And they are on barges. And they do manage to have cable or satellite TV. That's the backside of the Elephant Hill trunk. Different view of the trunk. Twin pagodas. Just some of the lush landscaping in the area. Colonel Sanders of China. And nightfall. That's from our hotel room. You notice there that's a live chicken that ladies for Sunday dinner. This is the entrance to a Club Med resort. We weren't staying there, so we weren't allowed to go onto the outside of the glass area there to take some photos, but the grounds are very, very pretty. There's a lot of statues there that we were hoping to see, but we weren't allowed to. That's the main driveway coming into Club Med. These are water buffalo. Chinese use them a lot for plowing and just hauling equipment around. Beast of burden, family of ducks, more views of the Karst Mountains. We're coming to the end of the video here. I hope you enjoy looking at these photos as much as we enjoyed taking them. I have more videos available at youtube.com/jimderry1.